Hello, I'm Armin. Welcome to CAE with Armin Hashemi channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to calculate dew point, relative humidity, and other psychrometric properties. In this model, I used a rectangle domain for air and three circle as heat elements. I used an array feature to create a linear pattern of heat sources. I use heat transfer in solids and fluids physics because air is a fluid and heat elements are solid. As I showed you before, we want to create temperature, dew point, and relative humidity plots. Okay, let's get started. First, I'll click on Model Wizard. Since our geometry is two-dimensional, I'll select 2D. Under Heat Transfer, I'll expand the section and choose Heat Transfer in Solids and Fluids because the problem consists of air and steel. Then hit on Add and Wait. As you can see, the physics interface has been added to the model. Next, I'll click on Study. For this example, I want to solve it as a steady-state problem, so I'll select Stationary and then click Done. Now, let's move on to the geometry settings. I need to create a rectangle for the surrounding air, so I'll right-click on Geometry 1 and select Rectangle. The dimensions are optional, so I'll specify 5 for the width and 2 meters for the height to define the air domain. Let's rename this domain to air. Next, we need to add a heat source element. I'll right-click on Geometry 1 again and select Circle. The radius of the heat source is 0.1 in this example, and I'll position it by entering 1 meter for both the X and Y coordinates. Well, its location is suitable now. Next, I need to create 3 circles, and a more efficient way to do this is by using an array. In the Geometry tab, under Transforms, I'll select Array. Now choose the circle domain. I'll change the array type to linear and specify 3 as the number of elements. The space between the elements will be set to 0.5 meters in the X direction. Everything looks correct, so I'll click Build All Objects. The geometry is now complete. Now let's define the materials. I'll right-click on Materials and select Add Material from Library. I need air and structural steel, so I'll double-click on each one. These 3 circles will be structural steel, and this rectangle will be air. Everything looks good. Now let's move on to the heat transfer physics. We need to assign the air domain as a fluid, and the 3 circles will be defined as solid. Now let's define the boundary conditions. Since the top and bottom of the air domain are considered infinite, we need to apply the symmetry boundary condition. Right-click on heat transfer physics and select symmetry. And then choose the top and bottom boundaries of the domain. We need to define another boundary condition. I'd like to specify the temperature for the left and right sides of the air domain. I'll right-click on Heat Transfer Physics, select Temperature, then select the left and right sides of the air domain. These 3 circles also need a heat source, so I'll right-click on Heat Transfer Physics and select Heat Source. I'm going to select these 3 domains. In the Settings window, change the source type to Heat Rate and enter 2 watts. With that, the physics setup is complete. Now we can generate the mesh. The initial mesh might be a bit coarse, so let's change the mesh setting to Finer and then click Build All. The mesh now looks appropriate. Now, we can solve the model, but we won't be able to calculate the dew point just yet. I'll set that up later. The solution is complete. We need to specify the psychrometric properties for the air domain. To do this, go to the Physics tab, click on Domains, and select Moist Air. This will enable the calculation of psychrometric properties. Now select the air domain. As you can see, we need to specify the relative humidity, temperature condition and absolute pressure condition. I don't have any specific values, but we can use data from COMSOL library. To do this, go to Shared Properties and select Ambient Properties. There are three libraries available. I'll choose ASHRAE 2021. In the Set Weather option, you can select the weather data for various cities, such as California. Now all of the temperature, dew point, wind speed, and other psychrometric properties are assigned from the ambient properties. Next, we have to go to Moist Air 1 and change User Defined to Ambient Relative Humidity, Ambient Temperature, and Ambient Absolute Pressure. As you can see, all properties are now received from the ambient properties. So far, everything is the same as before. We need to change the model's temperature to the ambient properties temperature to correctly calculate the dew point and other psychrometrics results. Also, I'll change the temperature boundary condition. Of course, this example is for educational purposes and not a real problem. It's time to solve the model again. Click on Compute and wait for the solution to complete. The solution is complete. Although the overall results haven't changed, we can now observe the psychrometric properties. For example, let's add another 2D plot. We'll also need to add a surface plot. Let's click on Add Expression button or Replace Expression. There is no difference. Expand heat transfer in solids and fluids, and we can find the moist air properties. Here we can see moisture content, saturation indicator, saturation pressure, etc. For example, let's select relative humidity and click on plot. This is the relative humidity graph. We can click on each point we want and see the results from the evaluation 2D table. Okay, let's create the dew point graph. I'm going to right-click on results, select 2D point, right-click it, and select surface. We have to click on Replace Expression, expand Heat Transfer Physics, and go to Phys CV. Here we can see dew point and equivalent temperature. I'm going to select dew point, and this is the dew point temperature. It's better to change the unit to degrees Celsius. Now we can see the dew point for each area in Celsius. This tutorial video has come to an end. Thank you for watching, and I hope you found this video helpful.